Dear online writing blogging community, I come in to you today with a blog update. Now, in this blog update, I'd like to discuss many topics, one of which, the main which, that I'll discuss, is that I'm talking about a type of poetry now, which is not, on the printed page or in the Word documents. If you take a little bit of a gander, if you take a little dip into some poetry books, Russian poetry, American poetry, do I have any more poetry books? American poetry. I only keep my favorite poetry books. American poetry. American poetry. American poetry. If you take a look at something like Westwind Review, which I love, out of all the journals publishing today, one of the coolest. Now, Kristen Gallagher. Now, it's cool, like, it's funny. All these things from Facebook, these are like my Facebook comments. Shout out to all my Facebook friends. If you are my friend, if you are on my friend at Facebook, I love you. Thank you so much. Please remain my friend. Do not leave me. I love you. Now. Thank God. Now. Sarah Palin. Doug Henwood likes this. Like. It's funny, right? It's funny to take that out of context and just, to present it in a situation, in a context, in which we are not expecting Facebook liking statuses, reminders, now. But what I do not like about this as much, there was a process involved in this composition. Now, Kristen Gallagher, I love her, actually I never met her in my life. But what she did, God bless her heart, everybody in Flark writing community does it practically, but I love them anyhow, but I'm just saying. Dale Earnhardt Jr. Poetry is going through all this filtering where, like, you know, it's like, it's taken and put into a Word document format. It's taken and put into a Word document format before it's called poetry. See, that I like what I'm doing with internet poetry, that tumblr.com, Tumblr blog for the future. Now, what I'm doing there is I'm making the screenshot of the original online context, the poem itself. Now, of course, you wouldn't even need a screenshot in order for it to be poetry. I consider many of my tweets going out to be poetry, regardless of whether I screenshot them with my screenshot, screen capture device. Now, but, however, tweets will get buried in your timeline. People are not going to click back to the beginning of your timeline and read all your tweets, probably. Facebook comments get lost very easily by falling way down in the feeds, by being drowned out by other things. What we can do with publishing is to document. So, and what I'm saying here is that, not that I'm against Word documents, per se, but that they have a tyranny over poetry. We've come to associate poetry with Word documents. I think we need to get over the idea of taking things from outside of poetry and putting them in poetry by putting them in a freaking Word document and putting them on a literary journal. I do not mean to suggest that just the screenshots are the only way of the future. Now, one of the newest forms that I have been getting so excited about has been the image macro format. Image macro by Omar. Image Macro by Alexander J. Allison. These bros are from the UK. The text is put onto a picture. It's maximum rebloggability. It's visually more interesting and compelling and immediately recognizable. My friend Aaron Steely. Ryan Hume has an amazing blog. Aaron Steely with an iPod telephone phone. Now, the possibilities are endless. These are only some of the possibilities. Paul Segal used, he actually did use Word documents, but made it look very different. Poems for the Millennium is an anthology book that has two volumes that were originally released together, and they have many visual forms. There's book art here. There's a lot of normal text though. That's kind of a little bit of John Cage poetry style. Next time that you're thinking, well, I will write a poem right now. Well, I have an idea of a poem. Well, I wrote down a poem on this notepad with me today. Or I wrote a poem on my iPhone. Let me go to my computer, type it into Word, send it to a literary journal. Let me go to my computer, type it into Word, save it into my document for my manuscript. I encourage you, please consider, what if you never put it into a Word document? What if you let it remain as a napkin that you photograph then? And then to document, to spread it, you take the photograph, and you can put the photograph on Tumblr.com. You can put it on Facebook.com and tag as many people as you want, up to 50 people. Or, what if you took a screenshot of it on your iPhone? This is where poetry is going, in my opinion. This is one of the most exciting things about poetry. There is no reason to keep it into just the Word document format. If you like that format, if that is your favorite format, then you can do it. I'm gonna love you. It comes down to it. It's me and you. I'm loving you. Never gonna give up on you. I was born in my own home. Midwife. I was not born in a hospital. It is spring. I am in Chicago. I live one block away from Wrigley Field. It is opening day of the Cubs.